Yo, what up, Dom Mafia? Welcome to another edition of the Dom Mafia Report. By the way, you like my jersey? Nice little Jeff Skinner action right here. As I'm sure you remember, maybe about 4 or 5 days ago, I did post something on my community tab saying that I was going to be conducting a Q&A session. Basically giving you a platform to ask me whatever question you want, whether it was Buffalo Bills related or whether it was personal. Now, this isn't clickbait. I know exactly what the title said. That is actually one of the questions that I will be addressing, so don't feel cheated. I had to get you to click this video somehow. Right before I dive into these questions, I do want to remind everyone that I am still giving away 2 tickets to the Buffalo Bills versus the Baltimore Ravens in New Era Field on December 8th. In order to enter that contest, you need to be a subscriber to this YouTube channel, screenshot proof, and tweet it over to me at RealDanMitchell and include the hashtag DonMafiaGiveaway. So that will enter you into the contest, and I will be announcing a winner on Black Friday, the day after Thanksgiving and the day after the Dallas Cowboys game. Without further ado, let's start diving into some of these questions. All right, first question. Do you think Brian Daboll will have a job at the end of the season? Starting off hot. This is probably one of the biggest topics that have been circulating around the Buffalo Bills community, especially the fan base. You'll probably notice last video that I did, I was not necessarily shitting on Daboll, but I did have my concerns. And the biggest thing in my eyes is he's just not using Josh Allen the way that Josh Allen needs to be used. I mean, hate to really compare the two, but just look at the Baltimore Ravens and Lamar Jackson. They're not trying to turn Lamar Jackson into something he is not. They are building a team around him, and they are calling offensive plays that benefit his skill set. What I think Daboll is doing with Josh and just the offense in a whole is that he's putting a leash on him. He's basically in his ear. He's making him super paranoid about making mistakes, and that is taking away what makes Josh so great, is his gunslinging abilities. I really think that if Daboll just lets Josh be Josh or play fearless, like he mentioned in that last interview he had, that I really think that they will be able to turn it around. If Daboll doesn't turn it around, then I do not foresee him having a job next year. I don't think it's smart for us to kick him to the curb in the middle of a season, especially when we're 5th seed in the playoff race and we have a winning season. I think his job is really going to depend on whether or not that we make the playoffs and then how far we actually go. So only time will tell. All right, next question. How many beers will you down during the game this Sunday? It's funny because I'm sure a lot of you have always wondered, why don't I ever do a post-game video once the Bills game is over? And it's largely because I am f***ing annihilated when I get home. And it's largely due to the fact that this bar that I go to has probably the best special on the face of the planet. They give you a 100-ounce beer tower, a whole pizza, and 12 wings for $25. So that's normally a go-to for me. And then before I even order that, I'm usually about 5 or 6 Labatt Blues deep after that. So I mean, I'd say probably the usual. I'll probably down a 12er to myself during that game. What part of South Carolina are you from? I currently live in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. I was born in Buffalo, New York, specifically South Buffalo, and then my family moved me down here when I was a kid. Luckily, the roots of Buffalo sports organizations have remained engraved right within my DNA, so I still follow Buffalo sports, and I actually go up there pretty regularly. All right, next question. Will the Bills win enough games and the Patriots lose enough games to make the Week 16 game for the division? That is actually a very interesting question, and me and some buddies were actually talking about that the other day. I'm sure that you noticed that it was just recently announced that game was actually flexed to a Saturday at 4:25, national television. Makes me nervous, because we all know how the Bills do on national television, but this year's different. This year's different. As far as the question is concerned, I think that there is a genuine opportunity for this to be for the division. Not because of how easy the Bills schedule is, minus a couple of tests, but the Patriots have a huge test ahead of them. They have, I believe it's like a 4-game streak where they play some very, very, very good teams. And especially coming off a loss against the Baltimore Ravens, I'm pretty sure they have the Chiefs, they have the Texans, and they have somebody else that I forgot, but they're a damn powerhouse. So wouldn't be surprised if our records are very similar by the time Week 16 comes around. All right, next question. How far can we make it into the playoffs? I mean, it's tough to say. It really is, because I mean, I'm sure y'all know that when it comes to somebody that puts themselves out into the sports media world, God forbid you give a bad take, then you just get torched for it for at least 24, 48 hours afterwards. On paper, we're going to make the playoffs. That's one thing that I can say 100% for sure. Not unless we have an absolute meltdown, we're going to make the playoffs, but it really depends on who we face. If like we play like the Chiefs, I mean, let's just hope that our defense can slow down Patrick Mahomes. Say that we play a team like the Raiders, then I think that we probably could advance right to the divisional round after that. So, I mean, I think at this point, it's only safe to say that we will see. Who do you think is the MVP for the Buffalo Bills this season? Hands down, John Brown. He is the most underrated wide receiver in the league. I'm pretty sure he's the first Bill ever for a certain consecutive amount of games with 50 or more yards per game. It is absolutely incredible what this man has been able to do so far. He is hands down our MVP. Say that we didn't have John Brown on this team, I really don't know what our offense would do. I mean, he is one of the few glimmers of hope that we have this year. John Brown, let's just hope that he continues to not only stay healthy, but keep up that same production. Why do you like the Bills? It's funny because I get that question a lot, especially living in South Carolina, when I tell people that I'm a diehard Buffalo Bills fan. 9 times out of 10, they're like, why? But of course, it has to do with the fact that I was born in Buffalo and the majority of my family still lives in Buffalo. But I mean, I've always been a fan of the underdog, man. I've never liked those super teams. I've never been a person to jump on a bandwagon or everything like that. And the biggest thing is that the Buffalo Bills fan base is by far the best fan base in all of sports. I mean, we go through years and years and years of emotional trauma, and we're still there. We're still there every single year. So that's why I like the Buffalo Bills. Will the Bills release Star and sign Jordan Phillips again? Not too sure about Star. I really haven't had time to go back and look at film of Star's performance, but one thing that I have seen, especially from a variety of Buffalo Bill media personalities, is that the opinion is split on Star. So some people are saying that Star is not performing right to the same caliber of his contract, while others are saying that he's still doing okay. So I really don't want to speak on that, but one thing I will say is, yes, we absolutely need to pay Jordan Phillips. He is an absolute stud and would not be opposed for us to use a little bit of our cap space during next offseason to extend that man, because he is producing. Who do you think the Bills will play first round in the playoffs? Like I was saying during that last question, right now, if the playoffs were to happen today, we would be facing the Kansas City Chiefs. A high-powered offense right against our very good defense. So, I mean, I personally would not like to play the Chiefs first round. I would much rather want to play the Raiders, but of course that would consist of the Raiders actually winning that division. I mean, it's tough. I mean, really at the end of the day, let's just take one game at a time and let's just go from there. All right. What are your thoughts on not trading for a wide receiver? I was so pumped that we did not make a move for a wide receiver. I really am. I know that a lot of fans were talking about, we should totally go for AJ Green. But I am so glad that Brandon Bean did not listen to 50% of our fan base for calling that out, because look what happened. He was out practicing for about 5 minutes, and now he's on IR and most likely is not going to be playing the rest of the season. Same thing goes with several other wide receivers. There was rumors that they were available, but nobody was available. That's the truth. And one thing that makes me feel very confident moving forward as well is, just saw something the other day, I believe it came from ESPN. Someone was quoted that the 2020 draft class is supposed to be the most talented wide receiver class to come in a very, very, very long time. So what do you know? Brandon Bean and Sean McDermott know exactly what they're doing. I really hope that we just go on ahead and we just grab an absolute stud from the draft. Just make it happen. Just based on your gut feeling, with eight games left, when do you feel Josh will hit the elusive deep ball and start lighting secondaries up? Soon as when Brian Daboll takes him off a leash. You heard Sean McDermott's message to Josh Allen, reiterated by Josh Allen during his press conference the other day, saying that he wants everybody on that offense to play fearless. Soon as when those first couple of games went through where Josh had a couple of interceptions, he just wasn't the same. A lot of that had to do with Dable screaming in his ear. Maybe a lot of that had to do with just his confidence going down the toilet with that kind of stuff. Soon as when, he just goes out there and he plays fearless. Hashtag fearless Josh Allen. That's exactly what we need. Soon as when he can go out there and soon as when he's not scared, he'll hit that deep ball. He really will. And I'm praying that it's this week against the Miami Dolphins because Josh is just an absolute monster against the Miami Dolphins so far within his short career. Well, guys, thank you for tuning in to yet another edition of the Dom Mafia Report. Just one more quick reminder, I am giving those tickets away, so make sure you enter my contest and be on the lookout for my preview video to the Miami Dolphins game. I'm going to try and drop that tomorrow. Let's go, Buffalo.